welcome to the Study Travel TV studios in London. I'm Nicola Hancox.
And I'm Scott Wade, bringing you the latest Study Travel news stories.
The headlines this week: presentation shows USA ELT suffering, but most destinations growing.
UK visa delays in Hong Kong impact on students and agents.
And UK looks to Chinese agents for junior growth.
So, the recent presentation by the National Language School Associations has shown most destinations doing well, Hanks, but the USA struggling a bit.
Yes, at the annual presentation of data and trends by the Global Alliance of Education and Language Associations, or GALA, last week, Cheryl Delk-Legood, Executive Director of English USA, said 70% of members suffered a downturn last year and added that 40% of respondents to a recent member survey anticipated further declines this year. The strong dollar, scholarship cutbacks, and political instability were cited as reasons.
Well, given that these are 2016 stats, it's fairly unlikely that the political instability they refer to was to do with the Trump administration, Hanks. But over this side of the pond, UK Chief Executive Sarah Cooper said that a major recovery was underway here in the UK following 3 years of declines, and Australia and New Zealand also reported success stories were continuing on their side of the pond.
Of the non-English markets presenting, Fidele Español España Executive Director Ana Cusar pointed to 5 consecutive years of growth, and Groupement FLE spokesperson Hilary Maitland said the French market was buoyant again this year.
Collectively, the 10 national language school associations that presented data welcomed some 1.1 million language students in 2016.
Now, over in the Far East, agents and students in Hong Kong have been affected by UK visa delays, with some students forced to miss the start of their academic courses.
According to figures published in the local media, more than 1,300 visas for Hong Kong students were delayed, although the British Embassy claims that the backlog has now been cleared.
A 24-hour call centre and email address was established for concerned parents and students, and Hong Kong Post drafted special measures to expedite the visas that were sent to and from the processing centre in the Philippines.
Britannia Study Link agency confirmed to Study Travel magazine that some 80% of applications were affected during August, which led to classes being missed and the rearrangement of flight and accommodation bookings, which is very bad, Hanks, very bad.
Now, in mainland China, the number of Chinese agencies promoting UK summer school courses is growing rapidly, according to a recently released study by the British Council and School Association, English UK.
Presenting at Study World, Su Si, Education Manager at British Council China, said Chinese agents have to register with the British Council in order to offer student visa programmes, and that there were 2,000 such registered agents at the end of last year.
Now, the number of UK short-term student visitor visas issued to Chinese students also increased by 26% in 2016, according to the report. Just over half of agents surveyed for the paper reported growth in UK summer courses in 2016, with a further 34% stating steady business.
More than 1,000 of the registered agents are concentrated in the Tier 1 cities of Beijing, Shanghai, Guangzhou and Shenzhen, while a further 750 are located in Tier 2 cities. The fastest growing cities in terms of agents included Suzhou, Tianjin, Kunming and Wuhan. This is what the authors are claiming anyway.
Great pronunciation there, Scott. And now for a roundup of some of the other stories this week. International House Belfast will offer a new teenage summer centre at Campbell College Belfast from next year. IH Belfast also unveiled a new virtual reality brochure for agents at the recent Study Travel Alpha UK conference. Did you see that, Scott?
No, I didn't, but it did look pretty cool. And staying with International House, IH Sydney has moved into vocational education with business and project management certificate and diploma courses in both Sydney and Darwin.
Oxford and Cambridge universities have taken the top two positions for the first time in the Times Higher Education rankings for 2018, while a number of Asian institutions have risen up the table.
The Asian tiger keeps growing, and secondary schools and juniors are growth areas for agencies in the Czech Republic, according to Study Travel magazine's latest agency survey, which shows the UK retaining its position as favoured destination, with increased shares also for Malta, Australia, the US and Ireland.
In our Grapevine Photo Gallery section this week, you will find photos from numerous Fram trips, school openings and fundraisers.
And Jenny, Matthew and Patrick from the Study Travel team are whooping it up in sunny Sevilla for the EAIE 2017 conference. We'll be sharing their report of that event with you next week.
Thank you for watching, everyone. We'll be back with more stories next week. Goodbye.
Tune in then. Goodbye.